Hello, and welcome to Storytime with Miss Bethany. I'm Miss Bethany. Let's talk about math. Math doesn't have to be flashcards or worksheets. Today, we're going to explore math with a scavenger hunt. I'm going to talk about some different math concepts, and then I'll look for those things in my apartment. Afterward, I'll post a list of the scavenger hunt so you can try one of your own at home. The first thing on our scavenger hunt is to find a square. A square is a shape that has four sides all equal length. I found this coaster. Is this a square? Let's see, it has how many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4. Are they all the same length? Yes, we found a square. The next thing on our scavenger hunt is to find a circle. A circle is a shape that is round. I found this pizza pan. Is this in the shape of a circle? Is it round? Yes, we found a circle. The next thing on our scavenger hunt is to find something that's shorter than 6 inches. So I have my ruler and I found this piece of pasta. So let's see how long this piece of pasta is. So I'm going to line it up with the edge of the ruler. And here's the 6-inch mark over here. So it's definitely shorter than 6 inches. It looks like it's about 1.75 inches, a little shorter than 2 inches. Did we find something that's shorter than 6 inches? Yes, we found this piece of pasta. The next thing on our scavenger hunt is to find a penny. So I have some coins here, and a penny is a coin that is round and the color of copper, kind of an orange color. So I have some coins here. They're all in the shape of a circle. They're all round. Is that a penny? It's round, but it's not copper colored. How about this one? Round, but not copper colored. Oh, right here we have a nickel. Here we go. We found a penny. Is it round and copper colored? We found a penny. The next thing on our scavenger hunt is to find something that is a pair. A pair is a set of things that have to be used together. I found a pair of gloves. How many gloves are there? 1, 2. Are they used together? Yes, you need one for each hand. We found a pair of gloves. The next thing on our scavenger hunt is to find something that is spherical. A sphere is a shape that is 3D, so it's round and all points on the outside are equal distance from the center. I found this ball. Is it round? Yes. Are all points on the outside equal distance from the center? Yes. We found a sphere. The next thing on our scavenger hunt is to find something that tells time. You might have different types of clocks in your house. I found a digital watch. So on the face here, it tells us the time in numbers. I also found an analog clock. So this is a clock that has hands and you read it to see what time it is. So let's see, it has the hour hand, it's pointing towards the 12. The minute hand looks like it's just one after the 12. And then we have the red second hand that's clicking by the seconds. So it looks like it is almost 12:02. We found something that tells the time. The next thing on our scavenger hunt is to find a pattern. So I found this shirt. And it has repeating stripes. So it has black, white, black, white, black, white. So this is an example of a pattern. What if I say a pattern? I'll say a pattern and you try to guess the next word in the pattern. Apple, banana, apple, banana, apple, banana, apple. What comes next? Did you guess banana? That's right. That's an example of a pattern. The last thing on our scavenger hunt is to find a rectangle. A rectangle is a shape that has four sides, two that are the same length that are longer, and two that are the same length that are shorter. I found this book. How many sides does the book have? One, two, three, four. Are there two sides that are the same length that are longer? One, two. And then are there two sides that are the same length that are shorter? One, two. This book is a rectangle. There will be a list of scavenger hunt items on your screen after this, and you can try your own scavenger hunt at home. Thanks for doing a scavenger hunt with me. Goodbye.